So far in November, the United States has clocked more than 4 million new cases of coronavirus. That means that every week this month, 1 million Americans became infected. And as the nation's top medical experts warn of a post-Thanksgiving surge, nearly 90,000 Americans right now are in the hospital fighting for their lives. My next guests are on the front lines of this pandemic every day. Allison Johnson is a registered nurse, and she's the director of the critical care unit at Johnson City Medical Center in Tennessee. And we have Dr. Ken Remy with us. He's a critical care physician scientist at Washington University Medical Center in St. Louis, Missouri. Dr. Remy, you work in the ICU. Over and over throughout this pandemic, we've put up charts and graphs showing the numbers. They're staggering, but nothing cuts through quite like personal experience. And I want you to share with our viewers what you see in a typical day.
So, Anar, thank you very much, first of all, for having me today.
Of course.
You know, since the beginning of this pandemic, we've seen lots of different people come through our intensive care unit. And over the past couple weeks, as you just intimated, these numbers have surged dramatically. And, you know, we're at a place where we're seeing so many people coming in that as soon as people are leaving, we've got people filling those beds right away. And in that context, we've had just too many people die so far. And, you know, that's what stirred me making this video this past week. But myself and my colleagues just have seen too many deaths. And we'll continue to take the best care we can for everyone's loved ones. We're just hoping to find some way to alter the trajectory, because this is just truly a major issue for us right now. And we're just hoping to get through this next couple weeks.
Yeah, Dr. Remy, I want to play that video now. It's very dramatic, but I think it gets the point across. Here it is.
This is what it looks like when you breathe 40 times a minute, have an oxygen level that's dipping well below 80. This is what it's going to look like. I hope that the last moments of your life don't look like this. Because this is what you'll see at the end of your life if we don't start wearing masks when we're out in public, when we don't practice social distancing.
It's really unsettling, but it speaks to the disconnect, right, between people on the street and people on the front lines. Dr. Remy, what's your message to folks with this video?
Undeniably, many people that get COVID disease out in the community are going to survive, and that's a wonderful thing. But once the disease progresses and you get sicker and you require hospitalization and unfortunately require being placed into an intensive care unit, your survival goes way down. Your mortality goes way up. I can't do much more than hopefully try to continue to do supportive therapies that we have right now. But there's no magic bullet right now to turn away that disease trajectory, except for we could hope that we could try to reduce transmission out in the community, because that'll help you probably more than once you get into the hospital and have this disease, and especially if you receive a breathing tube. So that's really what I hope for.
Now, Allison, I'm hoping that you could please walk us through what one of your shifts look like right now, and how does it compare to a shift pre-COVID?
So recently we had, in my opinion, one of the most difficult days that we've had so far. I mean, every day seems to be a challenge, and our team rises to the occasion day after day, but we're getting tired and the shifts are getting longer and the acuity is higher. And on this particular morning, we had three patients that passed away before 10:30. We had rapid responses on other patients that were deteriorating quickly. We were constantly rearranging and making higher acuity beds. And it's just hard. We have, that day we had five families come in for end of life discussions. And so we'd already had those three patients pass away, and we're bringing in families to meet with the physicians and our team to talk about, you know, the next five patients that we know we're going to lose. And it really takes a toll mentally and emotionally.
And Allison, I really want to dig into what you just said, because as we're watching these pandemic numbers go up, there's also the fact that there are suicide rates among health workers that are also climbing. And there is a very serious toll on mental health when you're seeing so much loss every day And I imagine a frustration that so many people do not take this virus seriously. For you personally, how does that make you feel?
It's really heartbreaking. Because our team is working so hard every day. We've experienced more death in the past few weeks than we ever have. I've been an ICU nurse for 16 years, and the experiences over the past several months and several weeks compared to nothing that I've experienced before. But we have a very supportive team. We have chaplains that help support us. We have great teamwork, and we lift each other up as much as we can. But when we leave work, and we see people out in the community that aren't taking the virus seriously, it's so disheartening. I had a friend who described it like being a firefighter, and a firefighter that works so hard to put a fire out, and then you turn around and you see your friends starting more fires. It's relentless and never ending. And so we need people to take this seriously. So if you have a healthcare worker in your life, or you know someone, or you know somebody who's been hospitalized by COVID, I would ask you to reach out to them and listen to their stories. I think, unfortunately, it takes the raw and vulnerable grief that our patients and their families are experiencing for some people to take this seriously. So reach out to them and listen to what they have to say.
Allison Johnson, Dr. Ken Remy, you know, the United States, the country, the world owes you and frontline workers like you an enormous debt, not just for what you're doing right now in intensive care units and hospitals, but for spreading this message that is so important for folks at home to hear. Thank you both again for spending your time with us this weekend.